So are we ready? Okay, good morning, everybody. So yesterday I shared with you the preliminary details in reference to the structure fire that developed into the double murder of a 30-year-old mother and her 10-month-old child, and the attempted murder of two of her other children, ages 4 and 5. So this morning, I'm going to share with you more of the details surrounding this tragedy, as this is the most horrendous and horrific crime that I've experienced throughout my entire career. I want to start with my victims. So first and foremost, I want to extend my heartfelt condolences to the family of the victims. My victim is a Denasia Moore, 30-year-old mother, who was found deceased inside of that apartment, who suffered numerous stab wounds. Also, her 10-month-old son, who was transported to Halifax Hospital, who also later passed away as a result of his injuries. And then the 5-year-old and the 4-year-old were transported over to Shands Hospital in Gainesville, where they remain at this time. And I believe they're still intubated at this time. My defendant in this is a Charles Leon Ivy. Here's his mugshot. He is 34 years old, and he is the father of at least two of those children. We know for a fact he's the father of the 4-year-old and the 5-year-old. So this is most definitely domestic in nature. The defendant has been charged with 2 counts of first-degree murder, 2 counts of attempted murder, first-degree arson. His criminal history is fairly minimal prior to this incident. He had some traffic violations, some possession of marijuana. There was a domestic incident back in 2016 on one of his former girlfriends. And in 2020, he was named as a suspect in a child abuse case involving one of the children. But that incident occurred outside of my jurisdiction. And I believe that case was no filed. But with what we witnessed throughout this investigation, the defendant in this incident deserves a special place in the gates of hell for what he did to this mother and these children. Again, I have never witnessed anything this horrific in my entire career. So the defendant did not confess to what he did, but what he did was he placed himself on scene. He put himself on scene around the time that these murders would have occurred. Through technology, we were able to track his vehicle via traffic cameras leaving the area after this incident would have occurred. And he was also in possession, admittedly, of the victim's cell phone. So we're still doing some legwork as far as the investigation goes, but the evidence is clear. The evidence speaks for itself regarding this defendant. I can't thank my investigators enough. Well, first I want to start with the responding officers. These brave officers, as well as the firefighters, if it were not for their actions, it's possible that the 4- and 5-year-old would have also passed away. But their swift action saved the lives of the 4- and 5-year-old because they didn't hesitate. They came on scene, they made entry, and they assisted in getting those children out. So I'm grateful to both my responding officers, as well as the firefighters and all the medical staff that responded to that scene. I'm also grateful for my investigators, because these investigators did not stop working on this from the time they responded to the scene. I know that's their job, but most people are out getting ready for the Thanksgiving holiday. They didn't get that opportunity because they were running down leads in reference to this investigation. My team is the best in the business. I firmly believe that. These investigators are top-notch and second to none. And I'm very proud to be their police chief. I also want to thank the state attorney's office. because without them, we would not have been able to get the arrest warrants. So, yeah, I'm sure there are going to be questions in reference to some of the evidence, but I'm telling you now, the evidence speaks for itself, and it was so much so that they were very comfortable giving us multiple search warrants and arrest warrants for the defendant. So I'm also grateful to the state attorney's office, and then I'm grateful to the Ormond Beach Police Department, because in the follow-up, this spilled over into their jurisdiction. So we had to do a lot up in Ormond Beach, and they were great hosts to us, and they also did a lot to assist in the investigation. So I'm very, very grateful to them as well. At this time, I'm gonna take just a few questions.
I know he didn't say that he did it, but do you know anything about a motive at this point?
I can only tell you that it's domestic in nature, and we're hoping that as the investigators continue to close up some loose ends, that we can get more of a clear motive, but right now the motive is not clear. It's still not clear. We may never get a clear motive to this, but again, this is the most heinous and horrific that I have seen.
Chief, you mentioned the mother getting stabbed and the children getting injured, but were they also stabbed by the man?
The 4 and the 5-year-old suffered no stab wounds, only the mother.
Okay, so basically their injuries were either smoking, inhalation?
Yes, their injuries were as a result of being left to die in a fully engulfed fire.
Okay, where was the guy caught?
He was caught at his residence, leaving his residence. There was a traffic stop that was conducted, and he was caught. I'm glad you mentioned that, because I also wanted to thank the criminal apprehension team, because they were instrumental in the takedown of the defendant.
You mentioned Ormond Beach. Was that where he was caught?
Yes, that he resides in Ormond Beach, and he was caught leaving his residence. That's where the traffic stop was conducted.
The woman that was with them driving the car he was in, she going to be charged with anything?
Nope.
She was third party, maybe? In this?
Yeah, she doesn't face any charges at this time. She cooperated with our investigation, and she's currently not facing any charges.
And just to clarify, you said the 4 and the 5-year-old didn't have any stab wounds. The mom did. What about the 10-month-old?
No, not that I'm aware of.
Chief, do the victims have any other family locally?
They do have family. I'm not sure if they're local.
How are they reacting to this?
Say it one more time. The victims?
The family of the victims.
They're obviously very distraught. They're very upset.
Chief, I know you said that the suspect was the father of the 4 and the 5-year-old. Did he have custody of those two children as well, or did she have
full? I believe the mother had custody of the children.
Is this completely premeditated? Did he go there with a gas can? I mean, was this all, what did you determine from that, or do you know?
That part is still unclear. But like I said, the investigation is ongoing, and I also wanted to thank the fire marshal as well. But I appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you.